raining earlier, but it looks like it stopped for the time being. It could come anytime because they said it was actually supposed to rain for the next couple of days. Lots of interesting drone stuff today. I guess we all heard the story in the US on how they want to get rid of Chinese-made drones. For example, companies like DJI for the fear that their products are spying on you, giving data to the Communist Party. And as we all know, companies like Parrot and Skydio, they were given grants, I guess, to make, I guess you could say, quote, like military-esque type of drones, like more high-end ones. Well, how about this one? This one apparently says, I guess, the Department of Defense in the US officially unveiled 5 drone companies that are, I guess, qualified to have their products be used for government services in these ways, I guess you could say. This one says, Defense Innovation Unit announces SUAS product availability to provide secure, capable, small unmanned aerial systems for critical uses across the government. Culmination of an 18-month effort will spur a stronger US drone industrial base for future innovation. Small drones have been widely available in consumer markets since the early 2010s and have notably been adopted by foreign military forces and non-state actors alike as inexpensive tools to gain a bird's-eye view of the battlefield. However, until now, the DoD has not had the opportunity to adopt these systems safely. Recognizing the demand signal across the federal government for trusted and secure SUAS, DIU took the lead in developing systems that are broadly applicable to an array of users and mission sets. Coined Blue SUAS, this spin-off effort builds upon the Army's initial success and offers SUAS that mirror the air vehicle and software architecture of SSR, provides alternative ground controller and radio configurations to accommodate a variety of users across the federal government. Both SRR and Blue SUAS comply with Section 848 of the National Defense Authorization Act for fiscal year 2020 that prohibits operating or procuring unmanned aircraft systems manufactured in China. The 5 companies whose products will be made available for purchase on the GASA schedule by September 2020 include AltaVN, Parrot, Skydio, Teal, and Vantage Robotics. So there are your new, I guess, 5 big players in the US when it comes to drones for government use. We already seen things, I guess, like Skydio and the Parrot drones. Basically, that one seemed to have the most press. I know, for example, Vantage Robotics is the one, if you guys remember that little Snap drone that was really small? So it's kind of interesting to see these companies get, I guess, more market share now. And based on all the text, basically it is because of, I guess, the concern of Chinese-made goods or electronics, like relying on them. And it says, we need an alternative to Chinese-made small drones, and Blue SUAS is a first step in achieving that objective, said Mike Brown, Director of the Defense Innovation Unit. Working across DoD and the US government, aggregates a business opportunity for these 5 vendors and enhances the long-term viability of this capability for the US and our allies. I guess it's almost like saying just like that, they pretty much just kicked DJI out of that section of a business, which I would assume is really profitable for a business, huh? But that doesn't necessarily mean they banned consumers from using it. Although, how much of an impact would it have on DJI? It was kind of interesting, I guess, reading this to think about that. This one says, Chinese drone maker DJI makes sweeping cuts and long march reforms. The world's biggest drone maker has slashed its corporate sales and marketing team from 180 to 60 at its Shenzhen headquarters in recent months, with similar cuts on the consumer side according to the people with knowledge of the matter. Its global video production team, once used to highlight DJI drones' filming potential, has shrunk from 40 to 50 people at its height to around 3 people. A marketing team of 6 has been let go in South Korea. Holy cow, that's quite a downsize. Although, according to this, it's more about things like the coronavirus and all that they're saying, but it makes you wonder whether or not it's because of stuff like this too, anticipating their drones being banned for government use in the US and all that. Although, according to this, DJI is saying that's more because they were growing too fast and they were hiring out of control, so now they're actually getting down to try to organize it. Which I know can happen in companies, when you grow too fast, too quick, all you do is keep hiring without actually considering, okay, is this the most productive way to do things? Like it says here, in response to Reuters' questions, a DJI spokesman said the company realized in 2019 its structure was becoming unwieldy to manage after years of strong growth. We had to make some difficult decisions to realign talent so that we can continue to achieve our business goals during challenging times, a spokesman added. He said Reuters' layoff figures were very inaccurate and did not take into account new recruits or internal transfer, but declined to provide specific figures. So this will be really interesting to see how this turns out. I know you still have things like those remote ID and stuff like that going on to the US to determine which drone should you get, I suppose, especially if you're doing things like government work and stuff like that. Although I think a thing to keep in mind is this is for government related uses. So to my knowledge, if you're using this just to capture like whatever, an event or something like that, then that should be okay. This is more for things I would assume like police uses in the future in the US. So I don't think people who has a DJI drone has to say, oh, that's it, I have to throw this away now. In a little bit of an irony as I think about it, one of the most annoying things about DJI products is their geofence and stuff like that. I know a lot of professionals, they'll say, hey, I have all the permission and stuff like that. What's this thing doing, like stopping me all the time? And if you think about it, they did it in a way, I guess, to look good too. Like the government officials saying, hey, our products are better, we have this and this. Yet ironically, in this case, the companies like the Skydios that were chosen like for the US, they don't have that stuff too. See you guys later.